Yeah, it's on. Okay. In 1 Corinthians 10:13, it says, "There has no temptation taken you but such as is common to man, but God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted." I'm going to raise this up a little bit. "Who will not suffer you to be tempted above that you are able, but will with the temptation also make a way of escape that you may be able to bear it." And to put it more simply, there's nothing unusual about temptation. Everybody gets tempted. But God is faithful, reliable, dependable, who will always provide a way to escape or resist the temptation. So what precisely is that way to resist and and escape temptation? Well, there's a little girl stood up in church and gave her testimony. She's about 10 years old. And she said, "Before Jesus came into my heart, I was a very naughty girl. See, the devil would come and knock on my heart's door, and I would open the door and let him in, and then I would do very wicked things. But when Jesus came into my heart, the devil went away. And I thought he was gone for good, but he came back and knocked on my heart's door again. And this time I didn't answer the door. I let Jesus answer the door. And when the devil saw Jesus, he ran away." James says, "Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Resist the devil, and he will flee or run away from you." So this little girl had the answer to how to resist temptation, how to escape temptation. And that is, when the devil comes knocking on your heart's door, you just let Jesus answer the door, and the devil runs away. Jesus said in Revelation 3:20, he said, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. And if anyone hears my voice, I will come in, and I will sup with him," or dine with him, fellowship with him. He says, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock." He says, "If anyone hears my voice," which means he's not only knocking, but he's pleading. He's saying, "Please, let me come in." And the door that's being spoken of is the door to our hearts. And the latch to that door is on the inside. And which means that Jesus cannot force his way in. He would not force his way in. We must unlatch the door, and we must let him come in. Now, this song I'm going to sing is actually three songs combined into one. And they're what's called altar call songs. And it's like a revival meeting, and the preacher is beginning to make his plea to the unsaved to come to Jesus. And these are the songs that are commonly sung in those meetings. "Without him, I could do nothing. Without him, I surely fail. Without him, without a sail. Without him, I would be dying. Without him, I'd be enslaved. Without him, life would be worthless. But with Jesus, thank God, I'm saved. Jesus, Jesus, do you know him today? Please don't turn him away. Oh, Jesus, my Jesus." "Without him, how lost I would be. The Savior is waiting to enter your heart. Oh, won't you let him come in? There's nothing in this world to keep you apart. What is your answer to him? Time after time he has waited before, and now he is waiting again to see if you're willing to open the door. Oh, how he wants to come in. Open your heart and let him in. God will remove all your burden of sin. He may not pass your way again. So open your heart and let Jesus come in. Take his hand, take his nail-scarred hand. Let him show you the way. Jesus will be your dearest friend. So open your